Hey, 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 everyone. Blockchain Bernie here. There is strife going on. Strife on the Solana chain. They just recently introduced a change request procedure. It's called SIMD, Solana Improvement Document. And they have SIMD 96 going on. And that is about your rewards, right? So with the recent congestion on the Solana chain, people have to pay additional fees to get their transactions through. This hasn't been the case just a few months back on the Solana chain. So you could just submit your transactions and they went through. But hey, good news is Solana is in demand. People want to get their transactions through. So they introduced priority fees, and priority fees are now the most part of the transaction fees that are being paid by people, right? It's like 98% or so of the transaction fees that are being collected on the Solana chain are for priority fees, right? So these priority fees right now, they go 50% to the validator that processes the transaction, and the other 50% are being burned. So now there is a proposal out there that says, well, don't burn these 50% because that might encourage validators to do side deals. There is no evidence so far of validators doing side deals. Probably some of them do. We don't. So we are operating the Xandeum validator here. A high-performance validator on the Solana chain, and we, you know, have never done side deals and will never do side deals that are secret from our stakers. So what we do now with these fees is some people say, hey, the validators, they will do side deals otherwise, so we don't want to burn those. And then there's others that say, hey, they were burned. Burning is beneficial to the whole community. But if they now go to the validators, that will just, you know, benefit the validators, but not the whole community. So both have a point here, right? So, but what that is all about, and that's what I want to tell you here in this little video, is how all these rewards affect you as a staker, and what different types of rewards are there. And will you get them from everywhere, from all the validators that you're staking to, from your liquid staking pools? And I'll dive into that. And if you like content like this, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel. And remember, Xandeum.com also has a points program under points.xandeum.org. So for liking this video, subscribing to my channel, you're connecting points as well. All right, so there are two things on the Solana blockchain. We have two things that validators have to do. One is validating, right? Validating means there are blocks that have been produced somehow, and a validator validates these, right? So that's why it's called a validator, right? But hey, believe it or not, that's only one part of the equation. The other part is, if you really think about it, there's only stuff to validate if it was created before, right? So there is block production and there is block validation. And those are the two tasks, right? And each validator has to do both. And please watch my other video about the TPU and TVU of a validator. TPU being the transaction processing unit, and the transaction processing unit is the one producing the block. And the TVU, the transaction validation unit, which validates these blocks. So validation happens way more often than block creation, right? That's kind of logical because each block will only be produced once, and then it will be validated by all 2,000 validators, right? So, and those validation, this type of validation happens through voting, right? So you vote that this block is valid. So that's the voting. The voting is for validation, and block production is the TPU, the transaction processing unit. So both of these produce rewards, right? And you're used to the normal validation rewards. And these validation rewards, they are up to like 7.5% on the Solana chain. And 7.5% of your SOL, you get back in additional SOL, right? Where is that additional SOL coming from? For validation, it's not coming from transaction fees, right? Because when you submit a transaction to the Solana chain, you want that transaction to go into a block. So you would want to pay a block producer to get your transaction into that block, right? So that's the block production thing, right? There, people that already have SOL, they pay for a transaction, they pay that transaction fee, and then that is going to be the block reward for the validator. And these block rewards, classically, they have been kept with the validator. The validators are not sharing these with you in 99.9% of cases, and I will give you some examples, some counterexamples later in this video. So normally, there are the block rewards, and there are the normal staking rewards, the validation rewards, and where do these SOL come from, right? They are your staking rewards, but the validator might get a part of it also if the validator has a commission turned on. We, as the Xandeum validator, we are at 0% commission, and it's been like that for over a year, and we're not planning to raise the commission anytime soon. So where are these all SOLs coming from, your 7.5% or so that you get in staking rewards when you stake to a high-performing validator, such as the Xandeum validator? Well, these come from inflation. So these SOL in the Solana protocol will be generated, newly created, just as a staking reward, right? So, but the inflation on Solana is less than 7.5%. It's maybe 5.5%, right? Why is that? Well, not everyone is staking their Solana. Some people are stupid enough to have SOL and not stake it. They are leaving money on the table. That's good for you if you have SOL and stake it, right? So that's for one. And also these things, you know, okay, so that's the reason. There's inflation, and these SOL through validation will be newly created. On the other hand, all the block rewards, and the block rewards, there are two classes, or even three classes, right? When you produce a block, you will get the base fee, the base transaction fee. Then, if that is a transaction that someone really wants in your block, they pay additional fees, the priority fees, for the validator to prioritize that transaction. So those are on top of that. And then there might be MEV rewards, right? Maximum extractable value. If you don't know what that is, watch my video about MEV on Solana right here. So there are three types of income: the base fee block rewards, the priority fee block rewards, and the MEV rewards. All these are, you know, related to block production, and they are, in many cases, not shared with you, right? So there's those 7.5%. But then there can be an additional, like 1.5% or so with the MEV. Those are on top of that. The block rewards can be another, like, it depends on how much demand there is for transactions, right? It can also be 1% even more in times of high demand, when people want to get a lot of transactions into these blocks. So those are valuable extra rewards for producing the blocks, right? And with so many validators through the Solana protocol, those will just not be shared with you as a staker, right? And that is part of the controversy and the strife that's going on right now in the Solana community. Because Anatoly, the founder of Solana, he thinks And he's been discussing that on X a lot. He thinks these extra rewards can be shared through liquid staking pools. And we agree with Anatoly here, right? There is other people in the Solana community that feel like it should be a change natively in the Solana protocol so that even stakers that stake native without a liquid staking pool can get their share of that. But Anatoly says that takes half a year until it's there, and it can just as easily be done in a liquid staking pool. And as you know, we have recently become fans of liquid staking, and we are working on our own liquid staking pool. We couldn't be more proud of that. And we will be sharing all these rewards with you with any of the validators that we are delegating to, right? So we are committing these validators to share their block rewards, to share their priority fees with you as a staker, right? And this will give this pool a way, way higher APY than you can have with just natively staking. Plus, you have all the advantages of a liquid staking pool. And we are doing that because we feel liquid staking, as it is right now on the Solana chain, is broken. My video about that is right here. Liquid staking broken on the Solana chain. So, what does this all mean? Our liquid staking pool is coming out soon. And there will be extra rewards, obviously, with a rewards token, right? So we had the block production, normally not shared, the regular voting APY, 7.5%. Okay, that's normally shared unless the validator has a commission. We have a 0% commission. And there's the MEV rewards, plus there is the rewards token. So we will have a rewards token in our Xandeum liquid staking pool. We're super excited about that one. And this will give you a gigantic boost on top of all these, right? So we will be sharing regular voting rewards, the standard transaction fees, the priority fees, the MEV fees, and you will get our rewards token, right? So this is all so, so exciting. And we will be the first liquid staking pool that enforces sharing these block rewards, sharing the priority fees through a tool that we've developed called Yield Defender. So your Yield Defender, and you know, all the validators that we're delegating to, they will have to use our Yield Defender in order to make sure they will be sharing these block rewards with you. It's not hard-coded in the Solana protocol. It won't be hard-coded in the Solana protocol for at least the next 12 months. But we're developing this liquid staking pool with the Yield Defender that gives you all these rewards. So that is another reason to please subscribe to my channel so that you stay up to date. But here's the thing. You also need to go to xandeum.com. And on the top right corner of our website, you find all the sign-up links. So you sign up for our email list, sign up for our X account, and sign up for our Discord. The Discord is super important because it's a live tool, right? It's a live chat tool, so you can chat with all of us live. And all three of these give you points if you subscribe there, right? The points can be super valuable because the pool will be there. There will be a rewards token. So you can connect the dots here, what that means for your rewards token allocation if you collect all these points up there. So this was my overview here of the strife that's going on Solana. I will vote for SimD96 and we will share all these rewards. So with SimD96, all the priority fees will go to the validators so that they can be shared, right? So with you guys, rather than just being burned, right? Being shared to the stakers. And yeah, this is all super exciting. I hope you stay with us. You know, watch all the videos that are coming. Get on our email list. Get on our Discord. Get on our X, so that you will get all the notifications once the pool will be launched, and I promise you it's not going to take long. And then we will start with that tool and that liquid staking pool, and it's going to be the first pool that shares all these different sorts of rewards with you. Thanks so much for watching today. Catch you guys later. Peace.